Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be painting these two bar stools that I have had for so long. I actually got these from the side of the dumpster. When I lived in my second apartment I ever lived in, someone literally put these out by the trash and I seen them. And at the time I had this little story time. I had this old Mustang and I literally shoved these in my trunk with the trunk wide open and drove them to my house because I was not leaving these bar stools behind. They are so sturdy, great quality. They've just got a lot of scuff marks. My dog has chewed on the wooden dowels that kind of hold the legs together. They've had a lot of love. So it's time to paint them, give them some new life. I am not going to be sanding them today. I am just going to clean them really good with some cleaner and then paint over them with some chalk paint, and hopefully they turn out okay. I don't have sandpaper and I live like so far from the store, it's just not worth it to go to the store for sandpaper. And I just have like the urge to paint today, so I'm gonna get it done and let's see how they turn out. Okay, so these are the bar stools that I'm going to be painting today. I am painting these white. I was going to just sand this down and restain these, which would be beautiful. But honestly, I don't know how it's going to turn out because of the material that these are. They're like a mixture between wood and like particle board. So I don't want to start sanding it down and then get to a point where I can't even stain it. I don't know. I'm just going to go ahead and just paint the whole thing white and just be done with it. But as you can tell right in here, we got tons of scuff marks. My dog took some bites out of it when she was a puppy. Just lots of scuff marks. They need to be reinforced a little bit because they're a little loose. But they are going to be white soon and distressed. So before I get started, I just wanted to show you the paint that I'm using. I'm going to be using this Kilts chalk paint. This is in the color white, but this honestly dries with kind of like to an off-white. To me, it is not pure white. Like you can see my nail is pure white and then that is like an off-white. That's how it dries. That's how my kitchen table looks. This is just leftover paint. I have a ton left. There is this is all the way to here still. So I'll get a ton of projects out of this. It was, I think, $16 for this little tiny can, which was really hard for me to spend. But like I said, this paint goes a long way and there's a lot in here for lots of projects. So I'm just cleaning off the bar stools using an old rag and some pine sol that I mixed myself in a spray bottle. I have talked about this before on my channel, but pine sol is one of my favorite cleaners. It works very well at getting all the grease spots and making the house smell very well. So I always like to use my pine sol, especially when I'm really trying to deep clean something.
To do this. I was gonna paint them white.
Whole thing?
Mm-hmm. I can't really sand this down. It's like that wood and particle board mix.
So the main reason why I was so nervous to paint these bar stools is because I didn't want to ruin them by painting them white and then not love them. Because at this moment right now, just the way they look, I love them. Even though they're worn out, even though my dog has chewed on them, my kids have put stickers on them, I love them the way they are. They're worn out by my family and I don't know, I was really scared to paint over all of that, but I'm so glad I did. I gave them a new life and just another chance. Now they'll just be able to get worn out by my kids for real this time. And yeah, I don't know. I was scared and I'm glad that I decided to do it. So y'all make sure y'all don't skip because you have to see this part in just a second. My kids are going to walk in front of the camera and they got their little face mask on and they are just adorable. I swear sometimes I don't know, kids do the cutest things ever and I just think it's adorable that they just want to help and they just want to be involved in so many ways. And I love that so much about my kids, even though sometimes it can get frustrating telling them to back up, don't touch. It is just so cute to watch these videos back and just watch Caden just be in his own little world and just in the camera. It's just adorable to me. And that's why I love to do this. This has been the most amazing job slash hobby I've ever had in my life because I get to watch my kids back on these videos. I get to show them these eventually when they're older. It's just a great way to document your life, but still earn money from it as well. So thank you guys so much because this would not be possible without you guys. So today it felt amazing outside. And if you don't know, I just recently moved back to Florida and y'all know Florida is hot. It is hot all the time and humid. It's perfect beach weather all the time, but when you live here, it gets old. But today it was so nice having just some fall weather for once. And it honestly just inspired me to get a project done. As soon as I stepped outside this morning to let the dogs out, I was like, what? It feels so good. What can I do outside today? And these bar stools have needed some love and attention for a long time. So I decided to go ahead and pull them out, get out my old chalk paint, well, some chalk paint that I used on a farmhouse table makeover. So if y'all haven't seen that, I will put it up on top of the screen right now so you guys can see that. But it was just chalk paint I had left over, and I decided to go ahead and get another project done with it. And also, I wanted to kind of test out the chalk paint on this material because I have another project coming soon. Actually, not too soon, but soon enough. And I wanted to try it out on this material to see how it would work, just to kind of get, you know, a better idea, because I do plan on redoing this hutch that I just bought for $25 at a yard sale. I will link that video down below if you want to see what it looks like right now and kind of give me some ideas what y'all think I should do to it in the comments below, because I am so excited for that. But anyway, I'm just going to continue to paint, get this first coat done, let it dry, and then I will do another coat. So one of the biggest tips I can give you whenever you're painting is to make sure that your brush strokes are going in the same direction and that you always go with the wood grain whenever you're painting. I promise this makes a huge difference on the end result because it just keeps everything very smooth and seamless. And last thing you want is to see brush strokes going in like five different directions. And in my case, I did not sand these, so I wanted it to look very smooth and just perfect without me even having to sand, if that makes sense. So anyway, this is how the first coat looked, and now I'm moving on to putting on the second coat, and then we will start distressing it.
All right, so after two coats, this is how the chairs look. There's still some like brush marks on it, but I actually like it. It looks like rustic. Someone commented on my last video where I did, not my last video, but the video where I did the farmhouse table makeover, and they said you can just wet a washcloth and like distress it that way. So I'm gonna try that like on a hidden area and see what happens. So it really is working. I actually really like the way it looks. I'm gonna go ahead and do the whole chairs and just see what happens. If it doesn't look the greatest, I'll just repaint it.
So this was a huge lifesaver because, like I told y'all at the beginning of the video, I live far away from the store and I did not want to go to the store just to get sandpaper. So using this method, first of all, saved me money and time because this looks so good. There's something about the wet washcloth that like peels the paint off, but it also gives like a white haze over the parts that like are worn. So it just makes it look like it was actually worn out by itself and not physically made, if that makes sense. So definitely give this a try next time you try out using chalk paint. And I cannot remember the name of the woman who told me about this, but if you're watching this video, please leave me a comment down below letting me know it was you, and I will pin your comment so everyone can know that you are the smart one who told me about this, because I would have never known this, and I've never seen anyone use this method before. Just wanna love you, just wanna hold you, just wanna be with you till we grow old. Please tell me you'll stay or take me away. I want you for myself every single day. You set my world on fire. You set my world on fire. Bye, 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 bye. So this chair is pretty much done. If I see some areas that I want to distress as I'm doing this chair, I will go back and do that. I'm trying to make them, you know, look even, but still look really rustic. But anyway, I love the way they turned out so far. I'm gonna go ahead and do a time lapse of me doing this one. So now that the chairs are all distressed and pretty much done, I just got to put the clear coat over them, and then I will give you guys a final before and after shot. By the way, this is the polyacrylic that I'm using. This is a clear semi-gloss, so it'll be easy to wipe down. This is the same thing I used on my table, the farmhouse table that I redid. I still have a lot left in there, so I'm going to go ahead and use that with one of these little foam sponges. Show you guys how I put this polyacrylic on. So what I do is I just like dip my little sponge into it, like a lot, and I start on one side and I go all the way, like one swipe, just like that. And I do that like all the way across, just like that. And you want like a, this is the second coat, so the second coat I try to do a little bit thicker than the first coat. And just go like that. And then once you get the whole thing coated, you're gonna lightly brush over it with the sponge to make sure everything is nice and even and there's no harsh brush lines. And you wanna make sure you go from like one end all the way to the next so you don't get like any bubbles right here. And then you're gonna take your sponge and run it along the side to catch any like little drip marks, just like that. Ta-da! And by the way, the polyacrylic does dry with a very smooth finish. I love the polyacrylic. I've tried polyurethane, I've tried all different types of sealant, but so far the polyacrylic is my favorite. So I also wanted to mention, in between coats, you want to make sure that your container is sealed and that you wrap your like sponge up in a garbage bag or like a Walmart bag or something, just to make sure that this stuff doesn't dry out, because it doesn't take long and it'll get hard fast. So I'm going to seal this up really quick, and then whenever the second coat is ready, I will open it up and finish the rest of the coats. So now the part that you all have been waiting for, the before and afters. There is nothing better than before and after. So this is before and this is after. And I think they look amazing. They look totally different. And honestly, I feel like you can see the detail of the chairs so much better now that they're white. Y'all let me know what you think down below. And please make sure you give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to be subscribed as well and have those notifications on. So when I do post more videos, you will get notified. But thank you guys for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye, everyone.